So, are you looking to learn Google Keep? Today, we've got a Dummies guide to Google Keep to show you around how to get started. Hopefully, it's the best guide you can find out there. And if you're new to this channel, make sure to subscribe to find the best productivity tools and apps. Let's dive into Google Keep. Welcome to this Google Keep guide. As you can imagine, Google Keep is available through web, iOS and Android, but it sadly doesn't have its own Windows or Mac application. But very simply, Google Keep is like post-it notes for the web. It helps you to create short notes, checklists, and even reminders as well. It's not as extensive as apps like Evernote or OneNote, but provides you a pretty neat way to create short notes for yourself and reminders for later. And if you have other experiences inside of your Google account, like Google Workspace, or maybe even a regular Google account with Google Calendar and Google Tasks, they actually do intertwine in a lot of places. In one demonstration in this video, I will show you how that's done. So let's go ahead and create a brand new note. All notes have a title and body text, allowing you to create the note in more detail. Now down here, you can have a range of different things. You can add a reminder to it. I'll show you that in a moment. And you can even add a collaborator too. So someone you can work together on that specific note for them to remind you too, or you to remind them. One of the best features of this, and why I call it the digital post-it note, is because they've got the ability to change the background. Now you can change the entire background and make it look exactly like a post-it note, or you can use some of their more recently added backgrounds for beautification to each of your notes. Let's just keep it simple and add it like a post-it note. So up here as well is once you click off it, it turns into a note. But you can also add an image to it if you wanted to. So that's perfect for capturing items that, for example, you've got something in the store or you've bought something in the store and you want to remember it again, you can snap it and add it to your experience. Now you can archive any of your items at any given time, and you can also add what's called a label. I'll tell you how that's useful for organizing for later. You can also add a drawing, which is a great way to add short sketches, particularly if you've got the iPhone or the iPad application and you've got a pencil that you want to go in a bit more detail and sketching something out. And the same goes with the Android tablet. You can also do a thing called show checkboxes. Now this is great for creating a very simple to-do list, and it's perfect for managing stuff for later. Now, if there's something that you created like a checklist that you don't necessarily want to tick off, it could be a shopping list, let's show you how, and a useful feature that can be helpful for that. Shopping lists are a great way to be able to just get started in Google Keep, and they're a helpful way to just make sure you're maintaining it for later. So let's say you've just got a very simple shopping list here. You can even indent items by pressing Command and this little icon symbol here. I could just press got it for here. But if I press close, you can see that the shopping list comes up here. Now, if you want this one to stay at the top, you can press pin note, and that's a great way to separate things in a bit of a different context as well, and you can give things different colors too. Now, that's what's great about the experience is if you've got different colors, you could color things, certain things that you want to search for later. So for example, you could have all of your shopping lists in a certain color and search for them. So you can search for purple. You can also search for yellow. So this is a great way in case you've created a color scheme that you can manage for later. Now, what's cool as well is you can also use Google's technology to use the things section. So for example, it detects when groceries are mentioned, and it can also detect when food is mentioned too. And this will expand based on what notes you add to your Google Keep account. You can also create lists as well. Anything with a checkbox is helpful, and anything with a URL that you capture can be searched and found inside of your account. So let me show you how the labels work. If you press edit label, you can add a label to your account, and this could be work, for example. If I press done, I can go to notes, and I can now see a new label appear in the left-hand side called work. Anything I add in this area allows me to have the label automatically added, which is helpful for keeping track and organizing stuff for later. If you want to save a bit of time, you can create a new list from here, a new drawing, and a new image straight from there. But if I go to notes, you won't see it appear unless you go ahead and you go to the more and you press add labels and select work.
Now, what's really useful is you can actually go over to reminders and see anything that has an upcoming reminder on. For example, if I wanted the shopping list to appear at a specific location, I can pick a place, or I can pick a time and a date, like next Monday, 8 a.m. is typically when I could go shopping, and you can see the reminder appears there. Now, if I go over to reminders, you can see that appear with the specific date that you have in mind. Now, if you're searching anything, you can find the reminders up here as well. Now, that's the general functionalities of Google Keep. There are a few additional ones that I'd like to show you. Up in the top corner, you can create a list view, which saves you a bit of time viewing things in more of a timeline view versus this grid view. You can also refresh your account up here, which will update if you're using multiple devices. If you go into the settings area, you can also enable a dark theme, which is helpful for seeing things at nighttime as well. This appears best on your mobile devices, but can be also viewed on web too. If I go over to settings, I can change a few things here. You can add new items from the bottom or have this switched off and move checked items to the bottom when they're completed. You can also display a rich link preview, which is perfect for capturing things on the web, and which they do have a useful Keep Chrome extension, which helps you to capture stuff on the go. You can also set reminder defaults, so you can really set when your morning is, your afternoon and your evening, and also default enable sharing or remove that if you don't want to accidentally share this with somebody. Now, there is also an archived area where you can see some of your notes that have been archived for later. Here's one that I created a few months ago, but you can see weirdly it's got this different thing added here. Let me show you how you can use Google Docs with Google Keep and save yourself a bit of time. So I mentioned earlier, if you're using some of Google's systems already, it might be helpful to use Google Keep as a simple note taker that you can capture stuff on the go. Now, as you can see inside of here, you can take notes, but what's great is whenever you take a note inside of a Google Doc, it'll pre-allocate that document, this meeting notes editor review, to the notes that you're doing. So if you're taking any notes, this is quite helpful for later. You can also remove the source if you want to, but this is perfect for backlinking it automatically into your account. Now, if you have an account, you can also press at, and you can be able to add a different note that you've got here for later. So what's great is if you're using Google Keep on this right-hand side, you can also search any of your keeps if you've got a long, extensive list of them. And if you have anything that is task-related that may sit outside of a checklist, you can use this Google Tasks abilities, in which we've got a full video about getting started with Google Tasks, which you can find on our channel. So folks, hopefully you found this video useful about how to get started with Google Keep. Google Keep is a great way to take simple notes, whether that's for your shopping list or items, or breaking down a few things that you want to checklist and prepare for later. It's not your Evernote or OneNote, but it will provide you a simple way to take quick notes, reminders, and organize them in a system that Google provides, especially if you're already in the Google ecosystem. Thank you very much, folks. I hope you found this video useful. Please do become a subscriber, Keep Productive, for more videos. Cheerio, folks.